Hello everyone, my name is Rubens Afonso and I'm going to present the work Trajectory Planning with a Dynamic Obstacle Cluster Strategy using Mixed Integer Linear Programming. The authors are Dr. Montagello, Professor Soma and myself. Trajectory Planning with MILP started in the early 2000s with the work by the MIT group. Other groups in the work quickly joined this work basically because of the many advantages of using MILP for trajectory planning. Namely, it can consider vehicle dynamics, enforce constraints over the variables such as acceleration and velocity constraints. It performs obstacle avoidance, time fuel minimization, and is able to handle multiple vehicles. What was quickly noted by these groups is that the computational burden was an issue because of the binary variables, both associated with the variable horizon formulation as well as with obstacle avoidance. The variable horizon formulation was then dealt with early in the literature in this publication using heuristics. However, the open question that remained was to deal with the number of obstacles that influenced greatly in the computational burden. In 2008, tunnel MIP was proposed by Beatles and colleagues. They performed a graph search to find a tunnel of polytopes that contains a collision-free trajectory, and then they performed the MIP with the choice of R constraints between the polytopes of the tunnel and not obstacle sites. Of course, this involved pre-processing. Prodan and others then performed an alternative encoding to reduce the number of binary variables associated with the number of obstacle sites, not directly with the number of obstacles. Dates and T-Drake then used ellipsoids to navigate through the free space and also reduce the number of binary variables associated with obstacle avoidance. Later on, Battagello and others proposed to cluster the obstacles in a pre-processing approach that considered the distance between the vehicle and the obstacles and also the distance between the obstacles themselves to choose to which cluster they belonged. This also involved pre-processing. In our proposal, we do not want to use pre-processing and rather we would like to do the clustering within the same MILP that solves the trajectory planning problem with the following advantages. It then performs optimal clustering, which is not chosen a priori at the pre-processing phase. If it is feasible with the number of clusters that we determine, then a solution will be found. It does not require any pre-processing, and it allows for a compromise between time and optimality. The original formulation involves the minimization of the time and the number one of the control variable. Since it is operated in closed loop, the state is then updated at every instant k. The states are subject to constraints as well as the controls. The position is extracted from the state vector, and the positions must not be within any of the obstacles as expressed by these constraints. The final state must be at a terminal set q, and the model is linear given by matrices A and B. For simplicity, we will present avoidance with rectangular obstacles and clusters. With rectangular obstacles, to perform avoidance, we have to be either to the left, to the right, above or below an obstacle. This is expressed by the following linear constraints. The problem with linear constraints for obstacle avoidance is that we can only express them as AND constraints. But we would like OR constraints for obstacle avoidance as one has to be either to the left or to the right or above or below the obstacle. This OR is implemented using the so-called Big M approach, in which we sum on the right-hand side of the inequalities a constant M which is large enough to render the inequality inactive for every achievable value of the left-hand side. We use also these binary variables to activate or not these constraints. For instance, in this case, if the corresponding binary variable is 0, then this constraint is active. If it is 1, it is inactive. Since we have to avoid collisions with obstacles of 4 sides in our example, only 3 of the binary variables are allowed to be 1 and relax the respective constraints. This means that at least one of them will be 0, and then the obstacle collision will be avoided as we will be either to the left, to the right, above or below the obstacle. Please notice that this requires 4 times an S times an O binary variables. In our proposal, instead, we would like to avoid collision with the clusters and not the obstacle directly. And then we perform this by defining a predefined number of clusters in C. If we avoid collisions with the clusters, we would like to avoid collision with the obstacles. And this will be true if it holds that every obstacle is contained in at least one cluster. Therefore, we have another kind of OR constraints that express that each obstacle I must be contained either in cluster 1, 2, 3, until and C. This kind of obstacle in cluster OR constraints can also be dealt with the Big M approach. Now consider that a cluster CL is given by this expression 7. Therefore, the cluster containment constraints can be rewritten by stating that the cluster left side must be to the left of the obstacle leftmost side. The cluster lower side must be lower than the obstacle's lower side, and so on. Since each cluster and each obstacle that is assigned is a decision problem, we have associated binary variables, and we relax these constraints with this Big M approach. However, if cluster L contains obstacle I, then the associated binary variable is equal to 1 and the constraints are imposed. If the obstacle is not contained in cluster L, then the binary variable is 0 and the constraints are relaxed. Since each obstacle must be contained in one cluster, the sum of the binary variables associated to obstacle I over all clusters must be equal to 1. Please notice that this requires then NC times NO binary variables. For a quick example, we notice that obstacle 3 here is contained in cluster 2 in the first situation, whereas it is contained in cluster 1 in the second situation. And we stress that this then yields a change in the associated binary variables. Notice that the binary variable here in case A states that cluster 1 does not contain obstacle 3, but cluster 2 contains it. And in the second situation, there is a change in the associated binary variables indicating that now obstacle 3 is contained in cluster 1. To avoid collisions with the clusters, it is a simple matter of reproducing the same constraints used for avoiding collisions with the obstacles. So we have to be either to the left, to the right, below, or above it. So it is just a copy of those constraints, but please notice that the number of binary variables is then 4 times NS times NC, as we have NC clusters instead of NO obstacles. Therefore, in our proposal, as compared to the original proposal, we reduce the number of binary variables from 4 times NS times NO to NO plus 4 NS times NC. And NC is a user-defined number of clusters. Therefore, we add control to the user as he can select a lower NC for lower computational burden, or a higher NC for higher computational burden and possibly a better cost. Simulation examples are used to illustrate the proposal. First, we would like to show the original one cluster strategy. Please notice that there are 4-5 obstacles and the vehicle goes from the leftmost position to the rightmost blue target set. On the right hand side, we see the cost at every iteration and its prediction at the previous step. There is no mismatch here. When you use two clusters, then initially there are two clusters with the lower cluster containing most of the obstacles and the upper cluster containing a few of them. And there is a narrow corridor between the clusters which is free for the vehicle to cross. Once the vehicle has crossed this narrow corridor, it does not have to consider the obstacles to the left of it. Therefore, since we are operating closed loop, a cluster could clusterize all obstacles to the left of the vehicle in one cluster. This would then free a second cluster to contain just these obstacles here, and free this amount of space for the vehicle to plan a trajectory that is shorter from its current position to the target set. This can be seen at the next time step when the clustering changes to free this chunk of space here now, which can be used by the vehicle to shorten its route. This is reflected in the graph right hand side, where the prediction of the cost at k equal to 7 is not equal to the actual cost because of this reduction. The maneuver ends at k equal to 13. With three clusters, we do not have this change in the cost because this initial amount of space is already free as we have the choice of three clusters here. Therefore, after crossing the narrow corridor, nothing changes in the cost because this third cluster was already there, as can be seen here. To summarize the results of computation time and cost in closed loop, please see the following table. The unclustered strategy has the higher computational cost with more than 300 seconds and the lowest closed loop cost, of course. With two clusters, then we dramatically reduce the computation time to 18 seconds and increase the cost to 24.8. A compromise is achieved with three clusters, where the computation time is between maximum and minimum computation time, and the cost is also between them. To conclude, we presented a clustering algorithm that solves the clustering within the same loop problem that solves the trajectory planning. This allows for a compromise between the number of clusters and the cost. We conjecture that symmetry in the optimization problem is what hinders the application with a higher number of clusters, meaning that the binary variables associated with obstacle cluster assignment and their constraints yield a symmetric problem such that many solutions have the same cost, which then make the computational time larger. Therefore, future work includes symmetry breaking techniques for application of this proposal with larger number of clusters, and also proposing how to deal with cooperating multiple vehicles. We would like to acknowledge CNPq, the São Paulo Research Foundation, the CAPES Foundation, and the Alexander von Humboldt Foundation. Thank you.